So welcome to modern mathematics. Why is it modern? Well, this is why. It's pretty cool, actually, once you get the hang of it. I mean, you can do stuff, like crazy stuff. That was close. Distributive property, and then we're also going to deal with the just an example, okay.
This is right here, the distributive property. So concerning the distributive property, we're going to go over a couple of forms of it. There are actually particular types, and throughout this, I'm going to write some stuff down here. And in particular, we're going to let the variables, aka letters, concerning this property, they're all going to be numbers. We're just looking at them in terms of real numbers. So let's get into it. So first thing first is that multiplication is said to be left distributive over addition. So it's left distributive. And we'll go over what left distributive means. Distributive refers to actually multiplication being both left and right distributive, and we'll kind of cover what that all means. Well, when we say something is left distributive over addition, it simply means that the quantity a times the number a times the quantity b plus c is equal to a times b plus a times c. And the way you want to think of it is that the a goes over here and we get this term, so it migrates over here and it gives this term, and then the a goes over here and it gives this term over here. So let's look back at this. So a times b plus a times c, that's how we kind of visualize it. And in particular, this can be extended to more complicated expressions such as the following. Let's look at this term right here. Okay, we're going to do the same thing we did here, except we're going to add some more variables. So, and all this is saying is that we take the number a and we move it over here, and it gives this term over here, a times b. And then we go here, we get a times c, it's over here now. And then this process continues through all those dots over there. That means there's could be other letters. And then all the way over here, a times z. We kind of picture the A zooming over to all our variables in this expression. And that's what it means to be left distributive over addition. Now let's look at what it means for multiplication being right distributive over addition. So previously we did left distributive over addition, and now we're going to look at right distributive over addition. And these terms are going to blend together, okay? So if you're confused by this, we'll make sense of this all in a little bit. And what right distributive means is that if we look at the quantity b plus c and we multiply that by a, that means that we bring the a over to the c term and it gives this term over here, and the a over here and it gives this term over here. This is what it means to be right distributive over addition. So let's get rid of that. And this too can be extended to more complicated expressions such as the following. All right, let's look at this quantity down here. We have the quantity b plus c plus dot, 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 other variables and other letters, whatever, plus z, the whole quantity, times a is equal to b times a plus c times a plus dot, 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 plus z times a. And we could think of the a term being over here first, or we could think of it multiplying the z term. It doesn't really matter which one we choose first. Let's just look at this because I did it this way last time. So we see the a term gets multiplied by the z, so we get this over here. And then the a term gets multiplied by whatever is over here. It would be x, y, and then we continue all this process down. We go all the way a times c, and we see that over here, and then a times b all the way over here. and that gives this term. So that's the kind of pattern for the right distributive over addition. So let's get rid of all that, all our scratch work. Now we say that, let's figure out what both these terms mean. Now we say that multiplication is distributive. What we were trying to do in the whole video is get to the distributive property. We say multiplication is distributive over addition if and only if multiplication is both left and right distributive over addition. So in other words, it means that we could do this or we could do this. Okay. So that's what the whole idea of distributive property is. So saying multiplication is distributive generalizes all these cases. So we don't have to worry about it being left distributive or right distributive. We just figure that these terms, whatever it goes from here to here, and here times here, and that process continues for the left distributive property. We know that holds true as well as the right distributive property, where we can kind of continue this process down here. So distributive means both left and right distributive. So what's important is that we know that distributive refers to this thing right here, as well as this thing.